thoracic movement. Mm-hmm. You just want to keep it straight like that.
Okay.
And a side view of here is perfect, so you're creating this angle.
Mm-hmm. So this is just a nice stretch. Other side
it is a good stretch, isn't it?
I can see the difference.
And you always want to do the yin and yang, right? You want to do the opposite.
Right.
Remember now, remember
this.
Right? So it's always shoulder width apart. And that's it. It's like you're driving. Yep. And just imagine that move. None of these are going to be over hyperextension type movements. You just want to create movement. Over time, it'll be great.
Mm-hmm.
You know, in the beginning when you're stiff, it takes a little bit of time.
Mm-hmm.
But your form is perfect. Good. So here's another. These are ones that we didn't touch base on. So you're going to create this angle right here. You're just going to bend your elbow up. That's the position. This is where this goes. This elbow stays close to your body. Imagine a towel or something that you don't want to fall out of. This is the movement one. This is going to push that shoulder out. So it's externally rotating. You're perfect. As long as that elbow stays to your body, you're good. So what don't we want to do with our upper body? Doesn't help us.
Okay.
Good.
Stable.
That's it. Oh, you're moving. You'll see that on the other.
Mm-hmm.
So what's a prop for this? This is one that I don't really go on the golf course. You can do this at home. Put your back against the wall. Right, so you're flat. You're not moving. So this prevents you. Let me see this real quick. So what you're doing a little bit is upper body's moving. So, back against the wall. Now we can't move. Same movement with your shoulder, but we're not adding this. Try with the other one, with your lead arm. So this goes into your hand. This one goes there. This elbow stays tight to your body. Push out that way. It's not as stretchy, it's not a word, but it's not as good as the other one,
mm-hmm.
but it's still pretty good. But it's still pretty good, sure. Absolutely.
So you get a lot of pain sometimes, right? Is that the insertion, the deltoid?
Deltoid tuberosity.
Oh my God, that touched me there. It's like that
right
spot.
There.
Yeah.
I like that you know that. I really do. You're very impressive to me.
Why was I so movie going this way? It's moving so much.
It's
because it's my weak side.
Yep.
Who knows? Everybody's got a, oh! You're aware of it. And that's why it's important to be educated, right? And shown correctly, like how you do with your kids. If you do it right, you get more out of it.
Mm-hmm.
Right? If you're gonna, exactly what you said. If you do it right, you get more out of it.
Mm-hmm.
And I like that a lot. Here's a great exercise without using the club, or you can use the club. Let me see what would be a better thing. I would want you to not use the club. Yes. So put your hand on your belt line. Grab your hand or your wrist and pull across, not up, across your belt line. And now watch my body. I don't want this. Just want to cross
out of my belt. It's going to help you.
That's putting you into internal. It's just stretching another part of your shoulder. So, right external does this. It's your end swing. Right, so it's here. But internal, what you're doing is your back swing. You're creating more space. Make sense? And all of them, I would do them, I would rotate them 2 to 3 times, 30 seconds. And that's it. You're done. You're getting ready to rock and roll just with your shoulders. Okay?